This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. South Dakota I, SA Theta Dikot, locally, is a state located in the Midwestern region of the United States. It is named after the Lakota and Dakota Sioux Native American tribes, who compose a significant portion of the population and historically dominated the entire territory. South Dakota is the 17th most expansive, but the 5th least populous and the 5th least densely populated of the 50 United States. Once the southern portion of the Dakota Territory, South Dakota became a state on November 2, 1889, simultaneously with North Dakota. Pierre as the state capital and Sioux Falls, with a population of about 171,000, is South Dakota's largest city. South Dakota is bordered by the states of North Dakota, Minnesota, Iowa, Nebraska, Wyoming, and Montana. The state is bisected by the Missouri River, dividing South Dakota into two geographically and socially distinct halves, known to residents as East River and West River. Eastern South Dakota is home to most of the state's population, and fertile soil in this area is used to grow a variety of crops west of the Missouri. Ranching is the predominant agricultural activity, and the economy is more dependent on tourism and defense spending. Most of the Native American reservations are located in West River. The Black Hills, a group of low pine-covered mountains sacred to the Sioux, are located in the southwest part of the state. Mount Rushmore, a major tourist destination, is located there. South Dakota experiences a temperate continental climate, with four distinct seasons and precipitation ranging from moderate in the east to semi-arid in the west. The ecology of the state features species typical of a North American grassland biome. Humans have inhabited the area for several millennia, with the Sioux becoming dominant by the early 19th century. In the late 19th century, European-American settlement intensified after a gold rush in the Black Hills and the construction of railroads from the east. Encroaching miners and settlers triggered a number of Indian wars, ending with the Wounded Knee Massacre in 1890. Key events in the 20th century included the Dust Bowl and Great Depression. Increased federal spending during the 1940s and 50s for agriculture and defense, and an industrialization of agriculture that has much reduced family farming. While several Democratic senators have represented South Dakota for multiple terms at the federal level, the state government is largely controlled by the Republican Party, whose nominees have carried South Dakota in each of the last 12 presidential elections. Historically dominated by an agricultural economy and a rural lifestyle, South Dakota has recently sought to diversify its economy in areas to attract and retain residents. South Dakota's history and rural character still strongly influence the culture of the state. Contents 1 Geography 11 Regions and Geology 12 Ecology 13 Climate 14 National Parks and Monuments 2 History 3 Demographics 31 Population 32 Race and Ethnicity 33 Languages 34 Growth and Rural Flight 35 Religion 4 Economy 5 Transportation 6 Government and Politics 61 Government 62 State Taxes 63 Federal Representation 64 Politics 7 Culture 8 Cities and Towns 9 Media 10 Education 11 Sports and Recreation 111 Organized Sports 112 Recreation 12 State Symbols 13 See also 14 References 141 Bibliography 15 Further Reading 16 External Links Geography Main Article, Geography of South Dakota Terrain and Primary Geographic Features of South Dakota. South Dakota is situated in the north-central United States, and is considered a part of the Midwest by the U.S. Census Bureau. It is also part of the Great Plains region. The culture, economy, and geography of western South Dakota have more in common with the West than the Midwest. South Dakota has a total area of 77,116 square miles, 199,730. South Dakota, and the Black Hills. The Missouri River serves as a boundary in terms of geographic, social, and political differences between eastern and western South Dakota. The geography of the Black Hills, long considered sacred ground by Native Americans, differs from its surroundings to such an extent that it can be considered separate from the rest of western South Dakota. At times the Black Hills are combined with the rest of western South Dakota, and people often refer to the resulting two regions divided by the Missouri River as West River and East River. Badlands Badlands National Park. Eastern South Dakota generally features higher precipitation and lower topography than the western part of the state. Smaller geographic regions of this area include the Coteau des Prairies, the dissected Till Plains, and the James River Valley. The Coteau des Prairies is a plateau bordered on the east by the Minnesota River Valley and on the west by the James River Basin. Further to the west, the James River Basin is mostly low, flat, highly eroded land, following the flow of the James River through South Dakota from north to south. The dissected Till Plains, an area of rolling hills and fertile soil that covers much of Iowa and Nebraska, extends into the southeastern corner of South Dakota. Layers deposited during the Pleistocene epoch, starting around 2 million years ago, cover most of eastern South Dakota. These are the youngest rock and sediment layers in the state, and are the product of several successive periods of glaciation, which deposited a large amount of rocks and soil, known as till. Over the area, the Great Plains cover most of the western two-thirds of South Dakota. West of the Missouri River, the landscape becomes more arid and rugged, consisting of rolling hills, plains, ravines, and steep flat-topped hills called buttes in the south. East of the Black Hills lie the South Dakota Badlands. Erosion from the Black Hills, marine skeletons which fell to the bottom of a large shallow sea that once covered the area, and volcanic material all contribute to the geology of this area. The Black Hills, a low mountain range, is located in southwestern South Dakota. The Black Hills are in the southwestern part of South Dakota and extend into Wyoming. This range of low mountains covers 6,000 of an ancient inland sea ecology. A pronghorn in Wind Cave National Park. Much of South Dakota except for the Black Hills area is dominated by a temperate grasslands biome. Although grasses and crops cover most of this region, deciduous trees such as cottonwoods, elms, and willows are common near rivers and in shelter belts. Mammals in this area include bison, deer, pronghorn, coyotes, and prairie dogs. The state bird, the ring-necked pheasant, has adapted well to the area after being introduced from China. Growing populations of bald eagles are spread throughout the state, especially near the Missouri River. Rivers and lakes of the grasslands support populations of walleye, carp, pike, bass, and other species. The Missouri River also contains the prehistoric paddlefish due to a higher elevation and level of precipitation. The Black Hills ecology differs significantly from that of the plains. The mountains are thickly blanketed by various types of pines, including ponderosa and lodgepole pines, as well as spruces. Black Hills mammals include deer, elk, wapiti, bighorn sheep, mountain goats, pine marten, and mountain lions, while the streams and lakes contain several species of trout. Climate. Köppen climate types in South Dakota. South Dakota has a continental climate with four distinct seasons, ranging from cold, dry winters to hot and semi-humid summers. During the summers, the average high temperature throughout the state is often close to 90. Form of blizzards and ice storms occurs often during winter. Monthly average high and low temperatures for various South Dakota cities: city January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. Aberdeen 21/1. 29 9 40 21 57 33 70 46 79 55 85 60 84 57 73 47 59 34 39 20 26 6 Huron 25 quarters 31 11 43 22 58 34 70 46 80 55 86 61 84 59 75 47 61 35 41 21 29 8 Rapid City 34 10 38 14 45 21 55 31 65 42 75 52 83 58 82 55 73 45 61 34 44 21 37 13 Sioux Falls 25 3 32 10 44 21 59 33 71 45 81 55 86 60 83 58 74 48 61 35 42 21 29 8 National Parks and Monuments. Mount Rushmore National Memorial in the Black Hills, South Dakota contains several sites that are administered by the National Park Service. Two national parks have been established in South Dakota, both located in the southwestern part of The State Wind Cave National Park, established in 1903 in the Black Hills, contains an extensive cave network as well as a large herd of bison. Badlands National Park was created in 1978. The park features an eroded, brightly colored landscape surrounded by semi-arid grasslands. Mount Rushmore National Memorial in the Black Hills was established in 1925. The sculpture of four U.S. presidents was carved into the mountainside by sculptor Gutzon Borglum. Other areas managed by the National Park Service include Jewel Cave National Monument near Custer, the Lewis and Clark National Historic Trail, the Minuteman Missile National Historic Site, which features a decommissioned nuclear missile silo and a separate missile control area located several miles away, and the Missouri National Recreational River. The Crazy Horse Memorial is a large mountainside sculpture near Mount Rushmore that is being constructed with private funds. The Mammoth Site near Hot Springs is another privately owned attraction in the Black Hills, a working paleontological dig. The site contains one of the largest concentrations of mammoth remains in the world history. Main article, History of South Dakota. See also, Timeline of South Dakota. Humans have lived in what is today South Dakota for several thousand years, at least the first inhabitants were Paleo-Indian hunter-gatherers, and disappeared from the area around 5000 BC between 500. Signed the 1858 treaty, ceding most of present-day eastern South Dakota to the United States. Deadwood, like many other Black Hills towns, was founded after the discovery of gold. Land speculators founded two of eastern South Dakota's largest present-day cities, Sioux Falls in 1856 and Yankton in 1859. In 1861, the Dakota Territory was established by the United States government. This initially included North Dakota, South Dakota, and parts of Montana and Wyoming. Settlement of the area, mostly by people from the eastern United States as well as western and northern Europe, increased rapidly, especially after the completion of an eastern railway link to Yankton in 1873. In 1874, gold was discovered in the Black Hills during a military expedition led by George A. Custer, and miners and explorers began illegally entering land promised to the Lakota. Custer's expedition took place despite the fact that the U.S. had granted the entire western half of present-day South Dakota West River to the Sioux in 1868 by the Treaty of Laramie as part of the Great Sioux Reservation. The Sioux declined to grant mining rights or land in the Black Hills, and war broke out after the U.S. failed to stop white miners and settlers from entering the region. Eventually, the U.S. defeated the Sioux and broke up the Great Sioux Reservation into five reservations, settling the Lakota in those areas in 1980. The U.S. Supreme Court and Congress ordered payment to the Lakota for the illegal seizure of the Black Hills. The case remains unsettled, as the Lakota refused to accept the money and instead insist on the return of the land. A harvest in South Dakota in 1898. A growing population and political concerns admitting two states meant having four new senators for the Republican Party caused Dakota Territory to be divided in half, and President Benjamin Harrison signed proclamations formally admitting both South Dakota and North Dakota to the Union on November 2, 1889. Harrison had the papers shuffled to obscure which one was signed first, and the order went unrecorded on December 29, 1890. The Wounded Knee Massacre occurred on the Pine Ridge Indian Reservation, commonly cited as the last major armed conflict between the United States and the Lakota Sioux Nation. The massacre resulted in the deaths of at least 146 Sioux, many of them women and children. 31 U.S. soldiers were also killed in the conflict. A South Dakota farm during the Dust Bowl, 1936. During the 1930s, several economic and climatic conditions combined with disastrous results for South Dakota. A lack of rainfall, extremely high temperatures, and inappropriate cultivation techniques produced what was known as the Dust Bowl in South Dakota and several other plains states. Fertile topsoil was blown away in massive dust storms, and several harvests were completely ruined. The experiences of the Dust Bowl, coupled with local bank foreclosures and the general economic effects of the Great Depression, resulted in many South Dakotans leaving the state. The population of South Dakota declined by more than 7% between 1930 and 1940. Economic stability returned with the U.S. entry into World War II in 1941, when demand for the state's agricultural and industrial products grew as the nation mobilized for war. In 1944, the Pick-Sloan Plan was passed as part of the Flood Control Act of 1944 by the U.S. Congress, resulting resulting in the construction of 6 large dams on the Missouri River, 4 of which are at least partially located in South Dakota. Flood control, hydroelectricity, and recreational opportunities such as boating and fishing are provided by the dams and their reservoirs. In recent decades, South Dakota has been transformed from a state dominated by agriculture to one with a more diversified economy. The tourism industry has grown considerably since the completion of the interstate system in the 1960s, with the Black Hills becoming more important as a destination. The financial service industry began to grow in the state as well, with Citibank moving its credit card operations from New York to Sioux Falls in 1981, a move that has since been followed by several other financial companies. South Dakota was the first state to eliminate caps on interest rates in 2007. The site of the recently closed Homestake gold mine near Lead was chosen as the location of a new underground research facility, the Deep Underground Science and Engineering Laboratory. Despite a growing state population and recent economic development, many rural areas have been struggling over the past 50 years with locally declining populations and the emigration of educated young adults to larger South Dakota cities, such as Rapid City or Sioux Falls, or to other states. Mechanization and consolidation of agriculture has contributed greatly to the declining number of smaller family farms and the resulting economic and demographic challenges facing rural towns. Demographics. Main article, Demographics of South Dakota. South Dakota Population Density Map. Historical Population Census. Pop percent plus or minus 1860 4837, 1870 11776. 1,435%, 1880 98,268, 7,345%, 1890 348,600, 2,547%, 1900 401,570, 152%, 1910 583,888, 454%, 1920 636,547, 90%, 1930 690, 2,849. 88% 1940 642,961 minus 72% 1950 652,740 15% 1960 680,514 43% 1970 665,507 minus 22% 1980 690,768 38% 1990 696,004 08% 2,754,844 85% 2010 814,180 79% S 2015 858,469 54% Source, 1910-2010-2015 Estimate Population. The United States Census Bureau estimates that the population of South Dakota was 858,469 on July 1, 2015, a 544% increase since the 2010 United States Census. As of 2015, South Dakota had an estimated population of 858,469, an increase of 44,289, or 544%, since the year 2010. 73% of South Dakota's population was reported as under 5, 24%. Under 18, and 143% were 65 or older. Females made up approximately 502% of the population as of the 2000 census. South Dakota ranked 5th lowest in the nation in both population and population density of the people residing in South Dakota. 657% were born in South Dakota, 314% were born in another U.S. state, 06% were born in Puerto Rico, U.S. island areas, or born abroad to American parents, and 23% were born in another country. The center of population of South Dakota is located in Buffalo County, in the unincorporated county seat of Gan Valley. Race and ethnicity. According to the 2010 census, the racial composition of the population was 847% white, 838% non-Hispanic white, 88% American Indian and Alaska Native, 12% African American or Black, 09% Asian American, 01% from some other race, 18% of two or more races. Ethnically, 27% of South Dakota's population was of Hispanic, Latino, or Spanish origin. They may be of any race. South Dakota Racial Breakdown of Population Racial Composition 1990-2000-2010 White 916% 887% 857% Native 73% 82% 88% African American 05% 06% 13% Asian 04% 06% 09% Native Hawaiian and Other Pacific Islander 01% Other Race 02% 05% 09% Two or More Races 14% 21% As of 2011, 254% of South Dakota's population younger than age 1 were minorities, meaning that they had at least one parent who was not non-Hispanic white. As of 2000, the five largest ancestry groups in South Dakota are German 407%, Norwegian 153%, Irish 104%, Native American 83%, and English 71%. German Americans are the largest ancestry group in most parts of the state, especially in East River east of the Missouri River, although there are also large Scandinavian-descended populations in some counties. South Dakota has the nation's largest population of Hutterites, a communal Anabaptist group which emigrated in 1874 from Europe, primarily from German-speaking areas. South Dakota has seven large Indian reservations shown in pink. American Indians, largely Lakota, Dakota, and Nakota Sioux, are predominant in several counties and comprise 20% of the population in West River. The seven large Indian reservations in the state occupy an area much diminished from their former Great Sioux Reservation of West River, which the U.S. government had once allocated to the Sioux tribes. South Dakota has the third highest proportion of Native Americans of any state, behind Alaska and New Mexico. Five of the state's counties are wholly within the boundaries of sovereign Indian reservations because of the limitations of climate and land, and isolation from urban areas with more employment opportunities. Living standards on many South Dakota reservations are often far below the national average. Zeebock County ranked as the poorest county in the nation. In 2009, the unemployment rate in Fort Thompson, on the Crow Creek Reservation, is 70%, and 21% of households lack plumbing or basic kitchen appliances. A 1995 study by the U.S. Census Bureau found that 58% of homes on the Pine Ridge Indian Reservation did not have a telephone. The reservation's isolation also inhibits their ability to generate revenue from gaming casinos, an avenue that has proved profitable for many tribes closer to urban centers. Languages. In 1995, the legislature passed a law to make English the common language of the state. As of the 2000 census, 190% of the population aged 5 or older speak German at home, while 151% speak Lakota or Dakota, and 143% Spanish. As of 2010, 9,346% 692,504 of South Dakota residents aged 5 and older spoke English as their primary language. 654% of the population spoke a language other than English. 206% 15,292 of the population spoke Spanish, 139% 10,282 spoke Dakota, and 137% 10,140 spoke German. Other languages spoken included Vietnamese 016%, Chinese 012%, and Russian 010%. Growth and rural flight. Over the last several decades, the population in many rural areas has declined in South Dakota. In common with other Great Plains states, the change has been characterized as rural flight. As family farming has declined, young people have moved to cities for other employment. This trend has continued in recent years, with 30 of South Dakota's counties losing population between the 1990 and the 2000 census. During that time, 9 counties had a population loss of greater than 10%, with Harding County, in the northwest corner of the state, losing nearly 19% of its population. Low birth rates and a lack of younger immigration has caused the median age of many of these counties to increase. In 24 counties, at least 20% of the population is over the age of 65, compared with a national rate of 128%. The effect of rural flight has not been spread evenly through South Dakota. However, although most rural counties and small towns have lost population, the Sioux Falls area, the larger counties along Interstate 29, the Black Hills, and many Indian reservations have all gained population as the reservations have exercised more sovereignty. Some Sioux have returned to them from urban areas. Lincoln County near Sioux Falls was the seventh fastest growing county by percentage in the United States in 2010. The the growth in these areas has compensated for losses in the rest of the state. South Dakota's total population continues to increase steadily, albeit at a slower rate than the national average. Religion: Eastside Lutheran Church in Sioux Falls. The largest denominations by number of adherents in 2010 were the Roman Catholic Church with 148,883 members, the Evangelical Lutheran Church in America Elka with 112,649 members, and the United Methodist Church UMC with 36,020 members. Both the Elka and UMC are specific denominations within the broader terms Lutheran and Methodist, respectively. The results of a 2001 survey, in which South Dakotans were asked to identify their religion, include Christian 86%, Protestant 54%, Lutheran 27%, Methodist 13%, Baptist 4%, Presbyterian 4%, Other Protestant 6%, Roman Catholic 25%, Non-denominational Christian 7%, Not Religious 8%, Other Religions 3%, Refused to Answer 2%. Economy: See also, South Dakota locations by per capita income. A B-1B Lancer lifts off from Ellsworth Air Force Base, one of South Dakota's largest employers. The current dollar gross state product of South Dakota was US$398. Agriculture-related industries such as meat packing and ethanol production also have a considerable economic impact on the state. South Dakota is the sixth leading ethanol-producing state in the nation. Another important sector in South Dakota's economy is tourism. Many travel to view the attractions of the state, particularly those in the Black Hills region, such as historic Deadwood, Mount Rushmore, and the nearby state and national parks. One of the largest tourist events in the state is the annual Sturgis Motorcycle Rally. The five-day event drew over 460,000 attendees in 2013, significant considering the state has a total population of 850,000 in 2006. Tourism provided an estimated 33,000 jobs in the state and contributed over $2 billion to the economy of South Dakota. Transportation: Main article, Transportation in South Dakota. See also, List of South Dakota railroads and List of South Dakota numbered highways. Beaver Creek Bridge in Wind Cave National Park. South Dakota has 83,609 miles, 134,556. Features: generally higher rates of population and economic growth than areas in eastern South Dakota that are further from the interstate. Also located in the state are the shorter interstates 190, a spur into central Rapid City, and 229, a loop around southern and eastern Sioux Falls. Several major U.S. highways pass through the state. U.S. routes 12, 14, 16, 18, and 212 travel east and west, while U.S. routes 81, 83, 85, and 281 run north and south. South Dakota and Montana are the only states sharing a land border which is not traversed by a paved road. South Dakota contains two national scenic byways. The Peter Norbeck National Scenic Byway is located in the Black Hills, while the Native American Scenic Byway runs along the Missouri River in the north-central part of the state. Other scenic byways include the Badlands Loop Scenic Byway, the Spearfish Canyon Scenic Byway, and the Wildlife Loop Road Scenic Byway. Railroads have played an important role in South Dakota transportation since the mid-19th century. Some 4,420 miles, 7,110. South Dakota's largest commercial airports in terms of passenger traffic are the Sioux Falls Regional Airport and Rapid City Regional Airport. Delta Air Lines, Frontier Airlines, and Allegiant Airlines, as well as commuter airlines using the brand affiliation with major airlines, serve the two largest airports. Several other cities in the state also have commercial air service: Aberdeen Regional Airport, Huron Regional Airport, Pierre Regional Airport, and Watertown Regional Airport, some of which is subsidized by the Essential Air Service Program. Government and Politics: Main article, Government of South Dakota. The South Dakota State Capitol in Pierre. Government: See also, Governor of South Dakota. South Dakota Legislature, and South Dakota Supreme Court. Like that of other U.S. states, the structure of the Government of South Dakota follows the same separation of powers as the federal government, with executive, legislative, and judicial branches. The structure of the state government is laid out in the Constitution of South Dakota, the highest law in the state. The Constitution may be amended either by a majority vote of both houses of the legislature, or by voter initiative. The governor of South Dakota occupies the executive branch of the state government. The Current governor is Dennis Dugard, a Republican from Garrettson. The state constitution gives the governor the power to either sign into law or veto bills passed by the state legislature, to serve as commander-in-chief of the South Dakota National Guard, to appoint a cabinet, and to commute criminal sentences or to pardon those convicted of crimes. The governor serves for a 4-year term, and may not serve more than 2 consecutive terms. The state legislature is made up of 2 bodies, the Senate, which has 35 members, and the House of Representatives, with 70 members. South Dakota is divided into 35 legislative districts, with voters electing 2 representatives and 1 senator per district. The legislature meets for an annual session which begins on the second Tuesday in January and lasts for 30 days. It also meets if a special session is called by the governor. The judicial branch is made up of several levels. The state Supreme Court, with 4 justices and a chief justice, is the highest court in the state. Below the Supreme Court are the circuit courts. 41 circuit judges serve in 7 judicial circuits in the state. Below the circuit courts are the magistrate courts, which deal with more minor criminal and civil actions. State taxes. As of 2005, South Dakota has the lowest per capita total state tax rate in the United States. The state does not levy personal or corporate income taxes, inheritance taxes, or taxes on intangible personal property. The state sales tax rate is 4%, but has been voted to 45%, which will come into effect the 1st of June 2016. Various localities have local levies so that in some areas the rate is 6%. The state sales tax does not apply to sales to Indians on Indian reservations, but many reservations have a compact with the state. Businesses on the reservation collect the tax and the state refunds to the Indian tribes. The percentage of sales tax collections relating to the ratio of Indian population to total population in the county or area affected. Ad valorem property taxes are local taxes and are a large source of funding for school systems, counties, municipalities, and other local government units. The South Dakota Special Tax Division regulates some taxes, including cigarette and alcohol-related taxes. Federal representation. See also, list of United States Senators from South Dakota and list of United States Representatives from South Dakota. South Dakota is represented at the federal level by Senator John Thune, Senator Mike Rounds, and Representative Kristi Noem. All 3 are Republicans. South Dakota is one of 7 states with only 1 seat in the U.S. House of Representatives. In United States presidential elections, South Dakota is allotted 3 of 538 votes in the Electoral College. As in all other states except Maine and neighboring Nebraska, South Dakota's electoral votes are granted in a winner-take-all system. Politics. See also, political party strength in South Dakota. South Dakota politics are generally dominated by the Republican Party since statehood. Republicans have carried the state's electoral votes in all but 5 presidential elections, 1896, 1912 by Theodore Roosevelt's Progressive Party, 1932, 1936 and 1964. Only Alaska has been carried fewer times by Democrat presidential candidates, not even George McGovern, the Democratic nominee in 1972, as well as a native South Dakotan, was able to carry the state. Additionally, a Democrat has not won the governorship since 1974. As of 2016, Republicans hold a 15% voter registration advantage over Democrats and hold large majorities in both the state House of Representatives and Senate. Despite the state's general Republican and conservative leanings, Democrats have found success in various statewide elections, most notably in those involving South Dakota's congressional representatives. In Washington, American Indians have been becoming more active in state and county electoral politics. In the 2002 election, American Indian voting carried Tim Johnson as the Democratic candidate by a margin of 532 votes until his electoral defeat in 2004. Senator Tom Daschle was the Senate Minority Leader and briefly its Majority Leader during Democratic control of the Senate in 2001-02. In 2012, South Dakota voted for Republican nominee Mitt Romney over Democratic President Barack Obama by a margin of 18%. In 2014, incumbent Republican Governor Dennis Dugard won a second term against Democrat Susan Wisemer. Incumbent Republican Kristi Noem defeated Democrat Corinna Robinson for South Dakota's at-large seat in the U.S. House, and former Governor Mike Rounds, a Republican, defeated Democrat Rick Wyland and former Senator Larry Pressler for the U.S. Senate seat being vacated by retiring Democrat Tim Johnson. Contemporary political issues in South Dakota include the costs and benefits of the state lottery, South Dakota's relatively low rankings in education spending, particularly teacher pay, and recent legislative and electoral attempts to ban abortion in the state culture. Main article, Culture of South Dakota. See also, List of people from South Dakota. South Dakota's culture reflects the state's American Indian, rural, Western, and European roots. A number of annual events celebrating the state's ethnic and historical heritage take place around the state, such as Days of 76 in Deadwood, Czech Days in Tabor, and the annual St. Patrick's Day and Cinco de Mayo festivities in Sioux Falls. The various tribes hold many annual pow-wows at their reservations throughout the state, to which non-Native Americans are sometimes invited. Custer State Park holds an annual Buffalo Roundup, in which volunteers on horseback gather the park's herd of around 1,500 bison. Black Elk, daughter Lucy Black Elk, and second wife Anna Brings White, about 1910 in South Dakota. Black Elk Lakota was a medicine man and Hayoka, whose life spanned the transition to reservations. His accounts of the 19th century Indian Wars and Ghost Dance Movement, and his deep thoughts on personal visions and Native American religion, form the basis of the book Black Elk Speaks, first published in 1932 among several editions. A premier annotated edition was published in 2008. Paul Goebel, an award-winning children's book author and illustrator, has been based in the Black Hills since 1977. Author Laura Ingalls Wilder used her life growing up on the frontier near Desmet as the basis of four of her novels. Laura Ingalls Wilder, whose semi-autobiographical books are based on her experiences as a child and young adult on the frontier, is one of South Dakota's best-known writers. She drew from her life growing up on a homestead near Desmet as the basis for five of her novels: By the Shores of Silver Lake, The Long Winter, Little Town on the Prairie, These Happy Golden Years, and The First 4 Years. These gained renewed popularity in the United States when Little House on the Prairie was adapted and produced as a television series in the Wilders' daughter, Rose Wilder Lane, who became a well-known writer in her own right, was born near Desmet in 1886. South Dakota has also produced several notable artists. Harvey Dunn grew up on a homestead near Manchester in the late 19th century. While Dunn worked most of his career as a commercial illustrator, his most famous works showed various scenes of frontier life. He completed these near the end of his career. Oscar Howe Crow was born on the Crow Creek Indian Reservation and won fame for his watercolor paintings. Howe was one of the first Native American painters to adopt techniques and style heavily influenced by the mid-20th century abstraction movement, rather than relying on traditional Native American styles. Terry Redlin, originally from Watertown, is an accomplished painter of rural and wildlife scenes. Many of Redlin's works are on display at the Redlin Art Center in Watertown. Cities and towns. See also, List of cities in South Dakota and List of South Dakota counties. Sioux Falls, with a population of around 160,000, is the largest city in South Dakota. Sioux Falls is the largest city in South Dakota, with a 2010 population of 153,888, and a metropolitan area population of 238,122. The city, founded in 1856, is located in the southeast corner of the state. Retail, finance, and healthcare have assumed greater importance in Sioux Falls, where the economy was originally centered on agri-business and